This is part two of how to graph equations by plotting points on the coordinate plane. The last two examples, we graphed two linear equations, and now I'd like to take a look at a couple examples that are not linear. Okay, so we left off by looking at this example, example one and example two. I'd like to take a look at how to graph y equals x squared minus one, again by plotting points. The technique is going to be the same. We're going to substitute x values into this equation and find the corresponding y value. We can pick any x value that we would like, but we do have to plot them on the coordinate plane. So I'm going to go ahead and pick negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2. Okay, so let's take a look at the first value of x that we chose. We chose negative 2. We're going to substitute that in for x. So we have negative 2 squared minus 1. Negative 2 squared is 4 minus 1 would give us 3. Okay, let's take a look at this on the graphing calculator just for a moment. When you're squaring a negative number, you do have to be a little careful. We do have to include the negative 2 in a set of parentheses to evaluate negative 2 squared properly. So negative times a negative is positive. Notice how if I leave off the parentheses, the calculator essentially squares the positive 2, then takes the opposite, or makes it negative. So we want negative 2 squared, it's positive 4. So be careful about that when you're using the graphing calculator. Okay, back over to our problem. Now we're going to square negative 1. Subtract 1, of course, you're going to get 0. And just to save a little bit of time here, when x is 0, y is negative 1. When x is 1, y is 0. When x is 2, again, y is 3. Okay, so we have five sets of ordered pairs. I won't write them out this time. I'm going to go ahead and plot them. Negative 2, 3. Negative 1, 0, 0, negative 1, 1, 0, 2, 3. Obviously, this is not a linear equation. It's actually a degree 2 equation, and it results in a shape called a parabola, which is kind of a U shape. One more example. We're going to graph x equals y squared. Now this equation is a little bit different than the rest of them because the y variable is being squared. X is equal to y squared. So in this case, it would be easier for us to choose values of y, square them, and then get x. A little bit of a change from the routine. Now we could pick x values, but it would make it much more difficult to find the corresponding y values. Okay, so essentially, in order to find the value of x, we just have to square y. So if I square negative 2, negative 4, and so on. Again, you can write these as ordered pairs, but we kind of get the idea from the last video. Let's go ahead and plot these points. Positive 4, negative 2, positive 1, negative 1, 0, 0, the origin, 1, 1, and 4, 2. And again, it's not a linear equation, and you can see it almost looks like a parabola turned on its side. Okay, I hope that helps you review how to graph equations by plotting points. Remember, each point represents one solution for the equation, and all of these equations that we've done, there's an infinite number of solutions. We just pick enough so we can make a nice graph of the equation. I'll leave you with a thought, and I hope that helped you understand how to graph equations by plotting points.